I welcome you all to this session on principle of classification. The principle of classification is come under the major area of structural analyzing the tale, folk tales, especially folk tales and tribal tales and all. It is very much needed in cultural studies as well as in the tribal studies. Every human society has enormous amount of folk tales, but the only thing is we need to collect that. And if we want to move further with the tales, means we need to study more on that tales, right? And the question is now here is like, you know, how to study a folk tale, right? How to study a folk tale? We can study a folk tale through many views. Like, you know, there are many school of thought to study about folk tales, especially like, you know, folk narratives from the oral tradition, the collected from the oral tradition. But you know, the folk tales is found in every region, every culture it is found. But how we are going to analyze the folk tale, that is important. Here we have you know, the idea of a principle of classification. Before going to analyze the folktale, we need to have the classification of the folktale, because the classification is very much important. You know, the way, like a collection, how the collection is important, like that the classification is also very much important before going to the analyze part. Here like, now I would like to propose this principle of classification for structural analysis of a folk tale. Like, through tales we can analysis how the culture and how the region is portrayed through folk tales, like through culture. Like, you know, it is an intangible cultural heritage of the particular region or community or the nation. But we need a certain, intellectual, discourse for the folk tales. You know, it is like the folk tales is not only for entertaining thing, but it has much the knowledge, of the people. It has much the vision of the particular group. So the vision. As we find a tale in a culture, so it is not enough to classify the tale, right? So after the collections of tales, we need to classify it. We need to have the classification first before going for analysis. So now what we are we will be doing is that classification, we need to do the classification. There is a set of ideas how to classify is proposed by various scholars in cultural studies, folklore and tribal studies, especially from from Finland. There was a scholar called Antti Aarne. He did a work on tale type. His collection was very limited. His collections was very limited within that Europe and some Asian countries and all. Then laterly we found that, you know, the folklorist and the cultural studies people, we found that, okay, this is not enough for classifying a folk tale. Then Stith Thompson came and did a work on motif-based classification in a folk tale. If we do a classification on a motif based, then we can have plenty of classification we can do for the folktales collections. So for motif, he proposed that the motif is based on certain independent characters or independent function, the characters and the function. Okay, like every folk tale we will be having a different personae, dramatis personae, and that dramatis personae will be doing several functions, right? So that through that, you know, that the content of the folk tales, Steve Thompson says, after finding the motives, every folk tale can be, can go for analysis. So now the thing is the question is in front of us is that how to find a motif in a tale. Okay, Steve Thompson said, folk tale, smallest unit in a folk tale is considered as a motif. In other words, a smallest meaningful unit is considered as a motif in a folk tale is a motif. Okay, then how to find it? How to find the motif? Okay, the definition about motif is very, very good, but how to find? I will tell you an example. In an ordinary tale or in any tale, okay, the characters all the characters will not be considered as a motif, but every tale has certain characters. How to find a motif is, for example, in a tale, mother element will be coming. That is ordinary. That is not a motif. Mother. If someone is thinking about, mother element is coming, and son is doing something, and uncle is doing something, that is not a motive. Okay, mother will be doing something, and father will be doing something, that is different. But the motive is the cruel mother, the cruel stepmother. Okay, the cruel stepmother, the adjective of particular element of that character, right? That is very important. That makes a motif nature. Okay, so I will wind up this session with this words of to find out motives. In the next class, the principle of classification 2 will be dealing about how to analyze a tale with that motif. Okay. So, dear participants and students, please go through the text which I have enclosed with this, the modules, and we will meet again. Okay, thank you.